Now we'll look at two more examples of solving rational equations. Normally we begin by identifying the values of x that make the denominator equal to 0 and exclude those values because we'd have division by 0, which is undefined. But notice for this first example, there are no variables in the denominator and therefore there are no values of x to exclude. Next we want to clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying both sides of the equation by a common denominator, hopefully the least common denominator. So looking at the denominators of 12 and 4, the least common denominator would be 12, since 12 is the least common multiple of 4 and 12. However, if we got stuck, we could use 12 times 4, or 48, to clear the fractions from the equation. So we'll begin by multiplying both sides of the equation by 12. So we'd have 12 times the quantity x plus 7 over 12 equals 12 times the quantity x minus 8 over 4. If it's helpful, we could write 12 in fraction form as 12 over 1. Notice on the left side, 12 over 12 simplifies to 1, and on the right side, 4 and 12 share a common factor of 4. 4 would simplify to 1, and 12 would simplify to 3. So now we have x plus 7 equals 3 times the quantity x minus 8. So now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we have x plus 7 equals, if we distribute, we'd have 3x minus 24. For the next step, let's get the x terms on one side. Let's subtract 3x on both sides. So we'd have negative 2x plus 7 equals negative 24. Subtract 7 on both sides. So we'd have negative 2x equals, this would be what, negative 31. Divide both sides by negative 2. And we have x equals positive 31 halves. Now let's verify our solution by graphing. To do this, we'll enter the left side of the equation into y sub 1, enter the right side of the equation into y sub 2, graph both functions on the coordinate plane, and verify our solution by finding the point of intersection. We should recognize 31 halves as 15.5. Let's just verify that. 31 divided by 2, because when we find the point of intersection, the calculator will give us the decimal form, not the fraction form. Now we'll press y equals, and for y sub 1 we'll have the quantity x plus 7 in parentheses, divided by 12, enter, y sub 2 will be the quantity x minus 8, in parentheses divided by 4. Now the x coordinate of the point of intersection is going to be 15.5, so we can't use the standard window. Notice if we try to by pressing zoom 6, we won't see the point of intersection. It's somewhere over here off the screen. But notice how we can also change the values on the y-axis to get a better view. So let's press the window key. Let's change the y-minimum to negative 5 and extend the y-maximum to 20. And let's change the y-values from, let's say, negative 5 to 5. If this doesn't work, we can always come back and change it again. Let's try pressing graph. So we're looking for the x-coordinate of this point of intersection here. So we'll press second trace for the calculation menu, option 5. Because we only have two curves on the coordinate plane, we can press enter 3 times. So enter, enter, enter. Notice how this does verify our solution is correct. Looking at our second rational equation, notice how x cannot equal negative 5, because if it does, we'd have division by 0, which is undefined. So if we get a solution of x equals negative 5, we would have to exclude that value. Now before we clear the fractions though, notice how we have a 9 on the left and a 6 on the right. Let's go ahead and subtract 6 on both sides to simplify this equation. Let's use the equation in the form 3 equals 5 divided by the quantity x plus 5. And notice in this form, we can see how the common denominator would be x plus 5. So now we'll multiply both sides of the equation by x plus 5. So we'd have 3 times x plus 5 equals 5 divided by the quantity x plus 5 times x plus 5. If we went to, we can write x plus 5 in fraction form as x plus 5 over 1. Notice on the left side we now have 3x plus 15 when we distribute. And on the right side, x plus 5 over x plus 5 simplifies to 1, leaving us with 5. Now we'll subtract 15 on both sides to solve for x. This gives us 3x equals negative 10. Last step, divide both sides by 3, and we have x equals negative 10/3. And once again, let's verify our solution by graphing. We can either use this form of the equation or this form here. Let's go ahead and use this form here. So we'll enter y sub 1 equals 3, and y sub 2 equals this quotient here. Let's get the decimal value of negative 10/3, which is negative 3.3 repeating. So this should be the x coordinate of our point of intersection. Now we'll press y equals, clear out the old equations, and enter the new equation. So y sub 1 equals 3, enter. Y sub 2 would be 5 divided by the quantity x plus 5. We do need x plus 5 in parentheses. And let's go back to the standard window by pressing zoom 6. So we're looking for the x coordinate of the point of intersection here. So we'll press second trace for calculation, option 5. Notice how the first curve is a line, which is good. We'll press enter. Notice how we are on the correct piece. If we were down here, we would want to use the right arrow to jump to the correct piece. Now we'll press enter and enter again. Notice how this does verify our solution. I hope you found this helpful.